Hello, I'm Chris Menard. Microsoft Teams has been around for 5 years now. It just had an anniversary. It came out in March 2017. It is now April 22 when I'm making this video. So 5 years and 1 month. I've been using Teams since it came out and I love it. A question that I'm frequently asked is when should I do a group chat versus a team? We're going to look at that in this video. I've got 5 reasons to help you possibly decide. I don't have any definitive answers for you, so you kind of have to look at these options and figure this out for yourself. But these are all 5 great tips. If you have more, please put them in the comments down below. Feel free to subscribe to my channel, ring the bell, and also my Microsoft Teams online training course is available. Right now it has 2 hours of material, and as new stuff comes out, I add it to the training class. Let's dive into this video right now. So I've got Teams running and I'm already on chat. I've got a chat going with Carol Wilson. In case you're wondering, how do you make a new chat? You come right here and click on new chat. But how do you make a group chat? I'm chatting with Carol and I decide, hey, I need to add some people to here. Up here in the top right hand corner, there is an icon. You click on it. It even says add people. And when you click there, you can start typing as many names as you want. There's Christian. Here's a tip for you. Don't hit add and go back and add more people if you need to. Just keep adding them all right here at one time. But I'm going to just hit add here. So I just created a group chat. Notice there's no conversation here. You may get an option depending on how many people are already in the group chat. If you add someone new, you may have an option. Do you want to let them see the previous chat history or not, or how far back you want to go? Another question I get asked is, do I still have a one-on-one chat with Carol? The answer is yes. It's right up here. That did not go away. It didn't get replaced. Just for right now, I told you I'm going to leave this here. So one of the main topics about group chat versus Teams, if you have at your company, your organization, your university, wherever you work, if you have a department, I usually recommend that a department be a team. And we'll talk about why in just a second. But one of the items about whether to have a team or whether to be group chat is how many people are involved. I just created this group chat. There's only 3 people involved. You can have 250 people in a group chat in Teams. It used to be 100. They've recently bumped it up to 250. One of my rules is the more people involved in a group chat, the more likely you should create a team and not do the group chat. Something just to think about, because if I have 100 people in a group chat, that's just way too many. So there's some number you've got to figure it out. Like, okay, there's too many people in this group chat. Also, group chats are easy to do. You just saw me create one. We talked about if you have a department, that's probably should be a team. But what if it's a project you're working on? Well, the duration of the project may determine group chat versus team. If I'm working on something in the project, hey, this is a 2-week, 3-week project. It's not going to take a lot of work to get it done. A group chat may just be perfect for that. But if you tell me this project is going to last 2 months, 3 months, or 4 months, I'm looking probably at creating a team for that project. So not only the duration, again, the number of members. Here's an easy one for you though. So some of these you have to decide yourself, but this one's an easy one. As you know, I talk about this all the time. I went back to Carol Wilson. I'm still in chats. The file structure for chats is files are stored in OneDrive for work or school. The file structure for Teams, and basically inside your channels, the files are stored in SharePoint. And the big difference is this. If I come over here to Carol Wilson, you can see all the files I have with her. I cannot create a folder structures. So sometimes, even when I'm doing a project with just one other person, if I know I need to create folder structures to manage that project or to make it easy, Even if it's a one-on-one and it's a short duration, I'll come into Teams. I'll make a team, have a general channel. I don't care if you add more channels or not, but now I can create folders. I'm making this up, 2025 budget. And we can put files in the folders. So that is one easy one for you right there. Another one to think about is chats are easy. You can always do a group chat. Your company may not allow you to create teams. So if I go to Teams, down to the very bottom, it says join or create a team. You may click there and you may not have this option to create a team. Some companies require you to fill out some form first saying, hey, why do you want the team? Who are going to be the owners of the team? Who are the members of the team? What is this team for? Because when a team is created, a Microsoft 365 group gets created, a SharePoint site gets created, document libraries get created in that SharePoint site. So a lot of stuff happens when a team gets created. Also, you probably should have naming conventions. My departments are DPT, my projects are PROJ. So you may not be able to even create a team without filling out a form first. That is a possibility. I believe I got it. I hope that is it. So the number of members, the project duration, file structure, the type of team, and also can you even create a team? Appreciate your time. Feel free again to subscribe, ring the bell. Have a wonderful day. Thank you.